Hey friends, welcome. Today we are going to discuss molecular weights of macromolecules or polymer. Now we know that polymers, they are made up of large number of small building blocks or small monomers which combine together to form a large polymeric chain. And during polymerization reaction, there are large number of chains which are propagating during the polymerization. So when we look at the molecular weight of the polymer, we cannot take the absolute molecular weight, but we need to take the average molecular weight. So we need to take the average of all the polymeric chains which are existing in the polymeric solution. Now there are different ways how we can express the molecular weight of macromolecules. Okay, so basically there are four different methods to express the molecular weight of the polymer. We will discuss one by one. So the first two methods are a most commonly used method. The first notation of molecular weight is number average molecular weight. So number average molecular weight, generally it is represented by MN bar, and number average molecular weight, it is defined as total weight of the polymer divided by the total number of molecules that are present. Okay, so it is nothing but it is the ratio of the total weight of the polymer divided by the total number of molecules that are present. So that will give us the number average molecular weight of the polymer. So suppose if we are considering that our polymeric solution contains several number of molecules or several number of molecules having or several polymeric chain having chain length N1, N2, N3 and so on, and the masses of this chain length, suppose they are M1, M2, M3 and so on. So the number average molecular weight, MN bar, we can write it as, so the mass, or we can say that N1 number of chains having mass M, so the total will be N1 into M1 plus N2 M2 plus dot 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 upon N1 plus N2 plus N3 and plus up to the number that we are present. So in general, the number average molecular weight can be written as summation Ni Mi upon summation Ni. So this is the general formula to calculate the number average molecular weight of any polymer. So suppose we are having over here N1, N2, N3 are the different number of polymer molecules and M is the mass. So number are given, mass is given, so we can easily find out the total molecular weight, or we can easily find out the number average molecular weight of the polymer. Moving on to the second type of molecular weight, that is weight average molecular weight. And weight average molecular weight, it is written as the M bar W. So in case of weight average molecular weight, the molecular weight of the species is multiplied by the weight of that species and not by the number. So in case of number average, we are multiplying the weight by the number. In case of weight average, we will multiply the weight with the molecular weight. So suppose if we are considering that W1, W2, W3, these are the weights of the species, and M1, M2, M3, this represents the molecular weight of the species, then the weight average molecular weight, M bar W, can be written as W1 M1 plus W2 M2 plus W3 M3 plus dot 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 divided by, we will have W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus dot dot dot. So in this way we can represent the weight average molecular weight. And suppose if we have that N1, N2, N3, these are the number of molecules having masses M1, M2, M3 and so on, then we know the weight W, or weight W, is nothing but it is number of moles into the molecular mass of that particular species. So over here also we have W, so I can write W1 will be equal to n1 into m1. Similarly, w2 I can write it as n2 into m2 and so on. So in place of weight, we can replace it by the number of molecules and the molecular weight. So we can write m bar w is equal to n1 m1, m1 and m1 will be m1 square plus n2 m2 square plus dot 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 upon, again we will have n1 m1 plus n2 m2 up to dot dot dot. So this can be generalized and written as summation ni mi square upon summation ni mi. So in this way we can represent the weight average molecular weight of any polymer, and it is always seen that the weight average molecular weight is always greater than number average molecular weight. After number average and weight average, there are two more types of molecular weights that are less popular or they are less famous as compared to the previous two, and these are, third we can say it is either sedimentation average molecular weight, or it is also known as Z average molecular weight, and it is represented by m bar z, and the formula directly we will take, m bar z is equal to summation ni mi cube upon summation ni mi square. So this is the direct formula for the z average or sedimentation average molecular weight, and basically this sedimentation average molecular weight is calculated by sedimentation method to determine the molecular weight of polymer. The fourth method is the viscosity average molecular weight. Viscosity average molecular weight, and it is represented by m bar v, and viscosity average molecular weight, it is given as summation ni mi raised to 1 plus a upon summation ni mi whole raised to 1 by a. So this is the direct formula to calculate the viscosity average molecular weight, and over here a is Mark Hawkins, that is a is our Mark, it is Mark Hawking's constant, and it relates the intrinsic viscosity with the viscosity average molecular weight. So it is Mark Hawking constant, and it relates the intrinsic viscosity with the viscosity average molecular weight. So these are the four different methods with the help of which we can determine the molecular weight of the polymer. And there is one more important thing to discuss, that is polydispersity. So polydispersity, generally PD, we can write it is the ratio of the weight average molecular weight to the number average molecular weight. And what is polydispersity? Polydispersity or polydispersity index, it gives us how much amount of polymeric chain or how much amount of different molecular weight polymeric chain are present in our polymeric molecule. This can be understood by taking the example that suppose we are having in a polymeric solution, we are having different molecular weight chains, and suppose I am having the molecular weight chain of range from 100 to say 10,000 and in one polymeric solution, and in second polymeric solution I am having molecular weight range from say 5,000 to 10,000. So in sample number one, the number of chains are more, and the number of chains or the range of the chains are more, and hence the polydispersity index will be more. And in second case, the we can say that the average or the molecular weight of or the range of the chains are less, and hence the polydispersity will be less. And if in case or if in case of any polymeric solution wherein only or all the chains are having same molecular weight. Suppose I am having a polymeric solution having same molecular weight, or all the chains are of same molecular weight, then under such circumstances the polydispersity index will be equal to unity, and we will have the number average or weight average molecular weight will be equal to number average molecular weight. And this type of solution or this type of polydispersed or this type of polymeric solution is referred as monodispersed polymer or monodispersed sample, but it is not at all observed in case of polymer. So when both number average and when weight average and number average molecular weight are same, then their type of solution is known as, or it is known as, monodispersed polymeric solution. And this question was asked in NET CSIR NET December 2017 question, which was around for 4 marks, and a molecular weight question was also asked for 4 marks. So polydispersity, it gives us or it tells us about the heterogeneity of the polymeric solution. Hope the topics are clear. Thank you very much.